Welcome to Auburn, Alabama, where the toughest ticket in town has become gymnastics. Every meet sold out for three straight years and no different for Senior Night 2024 as the Auburn Tigers welcome in the Tigers of Missouri. Here's where we stand late in the regular season, heading to the SEC Championships. You've got to be in the top four to be in the evening session. You can see right now Auburn and Missouri on the outside looking in. With Olympic medalist Kathy Johnson-Clark, I'm Alex Perlman. And Kathy, it's 12 versus 13 in the rankings. These two teams just about as evenly matched as possible.
That creates such an exciting dynamic for a close competition. But if you look deeper into the stats, you'll see that Auburn has the higher scoring potential for the team score. But Missouri has been so much more consistent, both at home and on the road. As weird as it sounds, Auburn needs to try to compete this like it's an away meet. Don't rely so heavily on that comfort of the Auburn home exciting crowd.
Well, we know we'll see that. And Missouri is coming in feeling really good about themselves with a season high 197.475. But the real highlight, Mara Titarsoli, perfect 10 on bars.
And this is the kind of routine you could judge under a microscope. Her form is just immaculate. Her technique, spectacular from start to finish, all the way through to a perfectly stuck landing, no deductions.
Auburn's really rounding into form as well, went into a tough environment at LSU and came away with a season high 197.1 on the road.
They have so much momentum, and it is really fueled by, check out all these season best career highs. That's the kind of performances you really want to build on.
Traditionally, Auburn dominates this series. Missouri has never even won here inside Neville Arena, looking to make history. But a big upset last season when they were not favored against Auburn and put up a 197.45. All right, we are ready to go. Auburn starts on vault, where they are 13th in the country. Sophia Groth, who is one of four competing in the all-around, three for Auburn, one for Missouri, will lead off. Competing all around for her 20th straight meet tonight. She's iron
woman. And Alex, you could see her talking to herself. This is exactly what you want to see. The focus on the gymnastic, a little off on the landing. So there'll be some deductions on the landing, but it was so clean and so pretty in the air.
Missouri on bars with a season high 49.5. Last week, of course, the program's first ever 10 by Titarsoli is the highlight, and we will see if she can duplicate that or put up a great score in the anchor spot. But Kira Burns will lead off, the senior from Blue Springs, Missouri, just set her career high with a 9.9.
She just moved into this leadoff spot, and the coach is really watching for her to improve her leg form, especially these first elements when she transfers from the high bar down to the low bar. So this is a blind change into a straddle Jaeger, nice same bar release, immediate transition to the low bar. Very smooth swing, nice job getting that final handstand. And the dismount, a double layout, just a slight leg separation, but really strong start for.
Absolutely stuck. Here is how a dual collegiate meet works in gymnastics. There's six gymnasts per team that compete in each of the four events. The five best scores count, so it's important the lowest is drop team with the highest cumulative score at the end of the four rotations wins, and it's home order, Olympic order, vault, bars, beam, and floor for the home team, which is Auburn here on senior night. Sophia Groth started with a 9.75, and here is Sydney Schumacher, the senior from Saratoga Springs, New York, also competing at Yurchenko Fall.
This is actually a 1.5 twist, actually in tuck position, so it's a 10.0 start value. That start value is determined by the level of difficulty, and this is an additional half twist to the vault we saw from Sophia, and she does it in a tucked position. So you'll see the legs are purposely bent for that tucked position, and they're happy to see it.
my mistake, a 1.5 from Schumacher. Amaya Marshall was originally in the lineup, but it's going to be the freshman Hannah Horton out of Brooklyn Park, Minnesota, which will sub in. Kathy, you've seen it many times. Coaches think that better scoring potential from a gymnast that gives them a great warm-up, and Hannah Horton put in for Marshall.
And this is the importance of depth. Usually the great teams have at least 7 or 8 gymnasts deep on every event. They will actually warm up. And in the event where somebody just looks hot and somebody else may be struggling with the timing on a certain event, they may make a last minute release.
Kira Burns' score coming in at a 9.825. Solid in the leadoff spot, and now here is Horton to follow up.
Watch closely these transition skills. These are the flight elements going from low bar to high bar. Beautiful handstand to set it up. That's called a Shaposhnikova, right down into a packed salto. Beautiful handstand pirouette. I like the legs glued together, really showing excellent form. Nice swing on this Giants, and a gorgeous double layup. That is a beautiful routine. Of course, she stepped back. They'll deduct for that, but I love the straight lines in that routine. Just really elegant bar work. Look at her legs glued together from the very beginning of the double layout. Just questioned a little bit that landing, so she took the step back.
Here's our first look at Olivia Hollingsworth, one of 6 seniors being celebrated tonight here on the Plains. At a 9.825 last week. We'll see her in the all-around, though, as well as her teammate and fellow senior night honoree, Cassie Stevens. She anchors the vault rotation.
This is a 1.5 twist in laid-out position. Perfectly straight body. Just makes it inside that line. Those 2 white lines on the mat show the judges whether the gymnast is directly in line down the center of the vault. She's a little off center, and then she hops to the left, stayed within the lines, but they'll take a slight misdirection deduction, and of course for the hop as well. But pretty in the air.
And Hollingsworth with plenty to celebrate. She recently got into med school, so congratulations to Olivia, who has done more than most of us can do, and she's not even done with college yet. Here's Holland Patrick, 9.825 for Kira Burns from Missouri to lead off on bars for the Tigers, and Hannah Horton's score came in at a 9.8.
Coach told us that Holland wants to try to turn this same bar release coming up right here, turn it over a little more, rotate before she regressed the bar to really keep that swing. And wow, lots of swing into that past a handstand, put it right on top of the bar. These handstands, you want to see the toes pointing to the ceiling. Double layout, oh, slight under rotation, so she had to hop forward. So the judges sit right on the side, and you want to see these handstands look effortless in the cast and end up right on top of the bar. Toes pointed to the ceiling. They can be within 10 degrees for no deduction, but these days, honestly, to be on the safe side, you want to be right on top.
And she was. You got to be right in that green zone, and no question Holland accomplished that. All right, here's Sarah Hubbard. So 9.75 at the moment for Sophia Groth is the score that Auburn would drop.
Very speedy down the runway, gets good block. Nice amplitude on her 1.5 twist.
Much better than last week, where she had a huge hop forward, only scored a 9.775, capable of as high as a 9.9 in her excellent career for the junior out of Phoenix. And boy, do we have a treat for you coming up here. On bars, Sienna Shriver, season high 9.9 last week, which started a run for the Tigers of 9.9, 9.9, and perfect 10 to finish out their season high rotation.
Coach told us on the call that sometimes Sienna can get just a little bit conservative on this event, especially on these first cast handstands. He wants to see her go really aggressively right here. Right on top. Beautiful work. Brittany Snowden is the assistant coach, and she coaches these athletes on the uneven bars. You can see her watching very closely and so pleased with that routine. Really strong and a great stick at the end.
Should be the best score coming up for Missouri on bars. At the moment, it's a 9.825. That was an excellent routine from Sienna.
Really strong work. I like the attention to detail I'm seeing with this team. Those legs are just glued together, not giving up any of those little deductions.
She is the one all-arounder for Missouri, so we will see her plenty. Julianne Huff now, the freshman from Alabama, career high 9.925 last week.
Yurchenko, one and a half twists. Now she is way off to the side. Notice she even landed on the outside of those lines. So when you take off toward the table, you need to be right in the center of the table and block and set first so that you continue that straight movement to the mat.
Sienna Schreiber's score comes in at a 9.9, the best of the rotation at the moment for Missouri, but two heavy hitters towards the end of this lineup, starting with Jocelyn Moore, second straight 9.9 at the Mizzou to the Lou meet last weekend.
This will be your first look at a release skill on the high bar called a ray. She's going to toe onto the bar right here and then fly backwards out of a giant swing. So actually, she did a Tkachev, not a ray. The Tkachev comes out of a giant swing. The dismount, full twisting double back, a little bit of an over rotation. So she had to hop back, but it was nice to see that chest so high.
Jackie and Andre love it. Making the trip, they come to every meet, Jocelyn told us.
There's that Tkachev. Notice it's a release skill that you fly backwards over the bar.
And here is Cassie Stevens making her 200th career routine appearance at this moment. 9.9 in the anchor spot last week for the reigning SEC vault champion. We're gonna have to count a 9.75 though at the moment. Need a big score here from Cassie.
She can deliver.
Yes,
an SEC national champion on this event. And every year, this vault has improved. She has worked so hard. It is the highest it's been, the farthest away from the table, the cleanest she has been with her form in the air. Hard work pays off, and she has been such a great contributor and leader on this team.
Kathy Auburn really needed that as well. They're going to be able to drop one of the 9.75s. Here is Mara Titarsoli. This is her only event with that perfect 10-0 in the anchor spot last week. At the moment, they're dropping a 9.8.
And this is a superb work of art. Stick. Oh, no.
That was
usually,
it. That was going to be
that
it.
Stick is right there. These handstands are glorious. And look at the toe point. So she goes above and beyond in terms of form. That is just a pristine toe point. And the dismount. Toes pointed throughout. Sometimes you'll see a gymnast start to flex the feet or they'll crunch their toes in the middle of that tuck. Nope, hers is just like a painting. It's so beautifully executed.
Well, you're gonna hear a lot about NQS or national qualifying score coming up in the next few weeks. Kathy and I break that down next here on Friday Night Heights. One rotation in the books here inside Neville Arena, and it is as close as we expected. The closest it can be, actually, just a quarter of a tenth separating Missouri and Auburn. Alex Perlman, Kathy Johnson-Clark back with you. And Kathy, as we get closer to the postseason now, the way we determine the rankings is about to start to shift.
So far, the national ranking is based on an average of every team's meet scores. Well, now they're going to shift to what we call NQS, or National Qualifying Score. And essentially, that is you take the top six team scores. Three of those must be an away meet score. Then you drop the high score and average the remaining five. So let's take a look at Missouri's breakdown. These are their top six scores so far this season. Three, at least three, have to be away. They have four counting. Now you're going to drop that top score, that 197.475, average the remaining five, and this is their NQS 197.1.
And Missouri has a real opportunity tonight, because if they can score higher than a 196.6, they get rid of that score against Kentucky, and that will increase their NQS. So that's kind of the magic number right now for the Tigers that you can watch throughout the meet. For both of these teams, though, Missouri returns home to close out the year. Auburn has multiple away meets still to go, so a chance for them to better their NQS down the stretch. This is their last home meet, even though we are not even done with February. All right, really tight one here after one rotation. And the second is where Missouri's going to go to vault, where Jocelyn Moore scored a perfect 10 against Auburn last year. And then the Tigers are going to go to bars, where we'll see this senior, Cassie Stevens. Coming up in the second half of our Friday Night Heights doubleheader on SEC Network, a chance to see the young woman ranked number four in the country on vault in Mackenzie Wilson when Kentucky heads to Arkansas. That's right, when we are done here inside Neville Arena, it is a close one. Just a quarter of a tenth separating Missouri from Auburn after one rotation. And now Auburn will head to bars and Missouri will go to the vault. It's going to be Sienna Schreiber to start off Missouri on vault, at 9.825 to lead off the meet last week.
The first half of Missouri's lineup, they're all performing their Yurchenko full twist. It's a 9.95 start value. Begins with this round-off entry into a nicely executed full twist. Good layout position. She had plenty of time to spot the landing. You're looking right at it. And a hop back, everything else besides that landing is pretty good.
Head coach Jeff Graba for Auburn looking for an improvement tonight from what he saw against LSU on the road. Just a 49-1 last week, Kathy. Jeff telling us that they just came out of the gate too tight, didn't hold their landings, which is a surprise because they've done it the last 2 months.
As I talked about at the beginning of the show, they really want to be in their bubble, meaning focus on the gymnastics. Hit these important elements, the handstand position. Keep the form throughout so far. This is being done as well as I've seen her perform this routine. Let's see if she can get this high-flying dismount, which is so up in the air, perfectly laid out. A little scoot back on that landing, but a nicely executed routine.
As we head back to the vault here for Missouri, what are the judges looking for?
So, of course, the start value. We talked about the level of difficulty. These first three vaults are a 9.95 max score. Execution, that's the technique. Watch for the block off the table, how high they bounce off that table. And then, of course, that landing.
Raina Light, the freshman from the Tampa Bay area.
When you do this vault, you want to get those arms back to the table really fast. Keep a nice open throw, gorgeous landing.
That kinda landing, like that, huh?
Yes, exactly, was really pretty. I like that her arms looked straight, no angle in the shoulders, maybe a little bit of an angle, but wow, what a landing, good for her.
teammates absolutely loving it. Her career high previously, a 9.85 against LSU in January. We will see where that score comes in. Sienna Schreiber in the leadoff for Missouri had a 9.8. Aria Brush leading off on bars for Auburn with a 9.875. And here is Olivia Hollingsworth. They had to drop her 9.775 last week.
So her release skill on the high bar is slightly different than we've seen. We've seen some of the gymnasts do a Jaeger in a straddle position. That's a front somersault. She's gonna keep her legs together in a piked position. Little leg separation going in. Almost looked like she had a little grip issue, but she corrected it before she swung down between the bars. Nice vertical handstand to set up the Giants before the dismount. This is a tucked full out, meaning that full twist happens at the end of the double back. Sometimes as you do this blind change and you switch your grip, right here she's gonna swing up half turn, and almost like she got just her thumb on the bar, had to sort of reposition that grip, really handled that well.
So here is Grace Ann Davis. 9-8, 9-8, 7-5, the scores at the moment for Missouri.
Powerful gymnast down the runway. Watch the amplitude that she sets up. Notice how the bounce off the table really gave her nice flight. Now, she only did a full twist, so that's the 9.95 start value. Remember, we talked about the start value being the level of difficulty.
Here's what judges are looking for on bars, Kathy.
We've talked about them all night so far. These handstands, perfectly vertical. And beyond that, you want to see straight arms into the cast. And then a complete vertical line from the hands through the shoulders, hips, and toes. And then these release skills. You're looking for difficult releases and also really high above the bar. And almost look like you're too far away to catch, so you just catch with those arms extended. And then, of course, high-flying dismounts.
Here is Sophia Groth now for Auburn.
Gorgeous handstand to begin. Good height on that release skill. Perfect distance from the bar. Paxalto a little bit loose in the back, but nice form. Here, legs really tight, very straight. Beautiful handstand. Sets up the dismount. That's a full pirouette on the bar into, I think that's her first stick here on the uneven bars.
And the trademark joy exuding from Sophia Groth.
She was so patient, really absorbed this landing. There's no under or over correction, just settles into the ground, brings those heels together. She may look surprised, but no, that was the plan all along.
She's had a 9.8 or better on bars every meet but one this year. That's probably gonna be another one. Hannah Horton.
Their first 1.5 twist, see that step back? That indicates she was a little under-rotated, meaning the somersault, the flip, didn't quite have enough rotation. Her feet were out in front of her, so her center of gravity was just a little bit back, so she had to step.
Grace Ann Davis's score was a 9.85. This is a great rotation for Missouri on vault. Those scores starting to build towards the 9.9 range with Jocelyn Moore and Amari Celestine still to come at the end of Missouri's second rotation. All right, Sophia Groth score just in as well with Gabby McLaughlin about to start her bars routine. Groth's 9.9. Very solid in the 9.725 at the moment from Olivia Hollingsworth, the score to drop.
So we talk about how beautiful gymnastics is in terms of the form and the artistry. Gabby shows that really well on this event. She also is so aggressive. She attacks every single skill. So she kind of has to settle down to make sure she can show everything off with the perfect form she is capable of. Beautiful Maloney up to the high bar to a pack salto, very, very slight leg separation, and a little bit beyond that vertical position on a pirouette. Perfect final cast handstand to a blind full and a tuck double back. Nice pointed to, oh, she was trying so hard to hold on to that landing, but the extra arm swing. They'll take a deduction for those arm swings, but she was trying to keep those feet planted, so at least not take a step.
And that brings us to Jocelyn Moore against these very same Auburn Tigers last year. Perfection.
Look at that beauty. Right down the center of the table. She flew high, 1.5 twists, and found a perfect landing.
First 10 for the program in almost 20 years.
She'd love another one right here. Oh, so close. Just a little scoot. Now remember, this year, this is the first time they've changed the landing rule. You have to hold that finish position, meaning after the landing. I'll break it down right here. There's the stick. She doesn't quite get it, and you're supposed to hold that. She's trying to, but had to scoot out of it. You have to hold it a full 1 second before you turn.
And now Cassie Stevens following up McLaughlin's 9-8. Stevens and then Olivia Greaves still to go right now for Auburn, who had just a quarter of a tenth advantage after one rotation.
I like the look of intense focus I just saw on Cassie's face. Toe on to a Ray. There's that toe on reverse hacked. A little bit rushed in that bail handstand. See if she can get the stick here. Dismount is a double layout. Oh, holds on to it. Great.
She held
so
it.
No step. She did hold on. The arm circle will be a deduction, but it's way better than taking a step. So. Look at her fight. She's on her heels, so her toes come up the mat. She held on. Coach loved it. Who wouldn't?
Now to anchor Missouri on vault, Mari Celestine, our first look. She'll compete in the final three events here for Missouri. Following up Jocelyn Moore's 9.875. The score to drop at the moment, Schreiber's 9.8 in the leadoff spot.
Usually her superpower is distance. Look at the flight off the table, how far she lands away from that table. The judges are looking for both height and distance as they execute this vault. She steps over that line. It's not an automatic deduction. Someday I think they'll revisit that rule. Those are guidelines for the judges to see if they're staying completely lined up with the table.
Here's Olivia Greaves, the redshirt freshman from Staten Island, former U.S. national team member. Her mom, Mary Jo, in the stands, who owns a gym, Athletic Edge, on Staten Island. Olivia basically grew up doing gymnastics. Not sure if she was going to have much of a choice of anything else from a young age. And man, is she taking it and run with it.
That was a beautiful opening release skill. You rarely see it. Very, very difficult. See if she can get this stick on the full twisting double back. So great to have her in the lineup finally. And what a long wait for her. Coming back from injury and then the wait has been so long. But check this out. It's called a church. She toes on and then stays in that piked position as she flies backwards over the bar. Very, very difficult.
You gotta get
as can be. My
gotta get,
goodness.
Gotta get the video. I would imagine there's some analysis that's gonna happen here in between as well. Coming up, we're gonna take a look at mental health awareness when Friday Night Heights continues right here on SEC Now.
Sure, I do things that fill my tank, and I take time to pour into myself, whether that's go on a walk, read a book, listen to music.
So for me, it's always taking care of myself outside of the gym. So whether that be taking an Epsom salt bath or meditating or journaling. Getting off of social media is the first thing that I do whenever I feel like my mental health is taking a decline.
Something that I've started really recently this last year in my comeback has been journaling. It's been really cool to just get my thoughts down on paper.
I like to journal. So I have my little journal that has a section that says what one good thing that happened today, one bad thing that happened today, what I'm thankful for, and my thoughts. So it's just a good way to reflect on the day and just keeping things in perspective.
Alex and Kathy back with you, and it is just so wonderful to see mental health being taken so seriously and a real change in the sport in a positive way.
My goodness, these women just took me back so many years because now I'm remembering the things that I did. I like journaling, I like taking walks, I listen to music. Of course, we had a Walkman or a CD, whatever that thing was, and we didn't have social media, so I didn't have to shut that down. At least they got so much to juggle, but so much more awareness of the importance of dealing with your mental health and that of your teammates and everyone around you.
There is no doubt, and hopefully that only continues to grow in the future as well as we get further and further along. Well, we are halfway home here inside Neville Arena. It is just as close as it was going into the second, and we can't wait to see Gabby McLaughlin coming up on beam for Auburn, and then you do not want to miss one of the most exciting newcomers in the country on floor in Missouri's Kennedy Griffin next. Auburn's gymnasts involved in community outreach activities in addition to their studies and gymnastics. A quick behind the scenes of their visit, going to the Food Bank of East Alabama, volunteering there. And, well, not a shock to see three Auburn gymnasts, Aria Brush, Olivia Hollingsworth, Cassie Stevens, as well as Missouri's Sienna Schreiber, nominated for the AAI Award, the top senior gymnast in the country. Kathy, usually likened to the Heisman Trophy of gym.
One of the greatest honors you could ever achieve is to simply be nominated for this prestigious award.
And inside Neville Arena, well, it's been razor thin throughout, and I guess we shouldn't be surprised that it's only a quarter of a tenth still after two rotations. It's number 13 versus number 12. It's multiple Tigers, which, Kathy, you taught me is called a streak or an ambush. Did not know that coming into this week, so you learned something new. Auburn will begin on beam. Here's Paige Zancan to get us back underway on the plains.
And that was a beautiful mount sequence. I love the originality, the press to the handstand, showing off strength, balance, and flexibility. Beautiful, solid work, secure landing on that layout step out.
This is Auburn's best rotation as well. Jeff Graba telling us so much confidence, their most solid lineup, and I'm pretty sure you're about to see why.
Really nice to see the full extension on those leaps. The judges look for that full 180-degree split in the air. Here's the dismount. Nice height on that roundup one. What a start. This is a freshman in the leadoff spot. I am so impressed with everything. I love everything about this routine and her performance. She has ice water in her veins. What a career she has ahead. When you find somebody who can take that leadoff position and run with it like that so confidently, that's money.
What a job, too, because she fell back on her dismount and was much, much better here this week. Sienna Schreiber in the leadoff spot for Missouri on floor, where they had a 49.525 last week, just shy of their season high. Four scores of 9.9 or better, and head coach Shannon Welker told us, we still weren't perfect. There's still plenty we can improve on.
This first pass of hers is a very interesting combination pass, a front full to a front layout into a stag jump. Oftentimes you'll see the gymnast perform a dance element out of those front tumbling skills. It's very clever, actually, because you can cover up any over rotation, not take a step.
Thank you.
front tumbling here. This is a front 1.5 twist. She just does some unique combinations, combining the tumbling with a dance element. Nice start from Missouri, especially in a meet with that is still just separated by 0.025. So close. This is the Rudy into a straight body layout and a split jump. The split jump was even higher than the tumbling.
You could say this might be the pivotal rotation here as well. It's really strength on strength. And now Aria Brush, who is celebrating her final meet inside Neville Arena. She is fantastic on bars. Her career high at 9.925.
And she's terrific on balance beam too. Led off a lot for Auburn on this event. He's now been pushed back to the second spot. Watch this leap series. Switch half, very difficult. They have to show two dance elements connected, two leaps connected. Series right here, back handspring to a layout step out. Oh, didn't quite follow through and attack that landing. That's a little bit of nerves slipping in there. You've got to really follow through aggressively and finish. Love how she got her composure back and is very solid again.
Not to fall, keep that scoring potential up because they might need to count this score. You never know.
Nice finish, gainer full.
Well, across campus, a lot to do here on the plains. All right, so Raina Light following up Sienna Schreiber's 9.85 in the leadoff spot. And remember, 196.6 is the magic number for Missouri. If they can get that by the final score, well, then they would be able to drop that 196.6 earlier this year and improve their NQS. So keep that in mind as these scores keep building.
This first pass is a combination, difficult 2.5 twist for the first skill in the air into a punch front. Front was a little bit flat, so it kind of traveled more than it went up. Like on beam, the judges look for those complete splits, full extension on the leaps.
Lana Kratzer, the cheerleader in the corner there for Missouri.
This is with a pike double back. Chest was a little bit low, but no movement of the feet, good control. Something nice for Euphoria fans out there. So this is a pike double back, and if you do it at the end of the routine, you get an extra tenth of bonus for doing that level of difficulty, a double back, and she does it in pike position.
Here's why Aria staying on the beam, though, is so important, because her score comes in as a 9.75. If she falls off, you lose 0.5 right off of the bat. So 9.75 is a score you can count and still win the meet. But, of course, they do want to drop that as Olivia Hollingsworth takes the beam.
Olivia is a really special athlete, very gifted. Acrobatically, she does a lot of difficulty on all four events. She has no weakness, really, making her a tremendous all-around gymnast. After her injury in freshman year, came back from a torn Achilles. At first, didn't have the confidence. She is now just flourishing, doing confident gymnastics. half to a split jump. Setting up for the dismount. There's a combination back handspring swing through into that gainer full. Excellent stick on the landing. Great routine. So they really want to be able to drop that 9.75 score, and this is how you do it. See how she followed through and finished that skill, really attacked the landing position, and then held on to a perfectly stuck wing.
Beautiful routine there for Hollingsworth, but Missouri is keeping the pressure on with back-to-back 9.85s from Schreiber and Light. And here is Horton, already three career-high 9.9-plus scores on floor. Bright future ahead for her.
This is an E pass, the highest level of difficulty. A double back with a full twist. A little bit of a slide back. They're allowed to take the lunge, a step into the lunge. But if that front foot slides, that's a little too big, and they'll take a slight deduction. Tumbling run here. Run tucked through to a 2.5. Oh, she got lost in the air.
Hoping to drop that score for Missouri.
Oh, that's too bad. I mean, once in a while that just happens, especially when you're doing these twisting skills. Some people do a double twist. We see a lot of 1.5 twists, some 2.5. So she does the front. Now watch here. She literally did a trip. Like, I don't even know if she knows what skill she did. She just, that was beautiful twisting in the air, but she just did not know where she was.
It's about to be Missouri's first sub 9.8 score of the night so far. Now Sophia Groth. Beautiful on beam.
Absolutely, she is so aggressive on this event. Aggressively beautiful, though, shows the elegance, but also the strength and the confidence to do a triple series. Do you see how strong that finish position was? You have to be that aggressive on this event to really master it. Lovely positions in those leads, really showing this off. This is one of the best routines so far I've seen Sophia do. See why this team is ranked 6th in the nation on this event. That was just excellent. Oh, darn, that step on the, at the very end, I thought she was gonna be able to hold on to the stick, because I love that her chest was up so high on that landing. Triple series here, you get bonus points for connecting these three skills. It's a requirement to do the acro series. And then, but see how she's back on her heels and those toes. You need your toes for balance. And when they come off the mat, really hard to hold on to it.
Following up Hollingsworth's 9.9. Chance for a little bit more momentum there. We'll see what the score comes in for Auburn. Lauren Williams is getting set to take on Kentucky. It's the Hogs and the Cats coming up when we are done right here on SEC Network from Fayetteville. Just a little bit of a delay here between the judges. And I would imagine it has something to do with Horton's last pass.
Yes, because I have in my notes a 2.5 twist, and that looked like 3. So that's not usually what happens. And they're probably discussing that, because obviously a triple is way harder than double and a 2.5. But she fell. So do you get credit for the skill when there is a fault? Like, they really have to discuss that for start value.
One judge right now has a 9.4. One of them has a 9.05. And those are too far out of range. So we will see what the final score comes in as. Meanwhile, we know Sophia Groth had a 9.9.
So keep in mind, the judges do not have instant replay like we do. So they can't go back and look to see what was the skill and then take off for the fall, but give her credit for the skill she actually performed. It's complicated.
Judging always is. We have learned that much over the years. And, well, we know that Missouri's going to want to drop it no matter what the score comes in as. They've gotten a couple of 9.85 so far. Remember, you can drop the lowest score, but Celestine Griffin and Moore need to hit in a big way. And there it is, a 9.3 comes in for Horton. But Celestine is who you want up there. Earned the share of her floor title with a 9.95 last week at Mizzou to the Lou. And this is a fun, fun routine. An ode to HBCUs, choreographed by her brother, Artion, who is a professional dancer, was on Dancing with the Stars Junior. And he's out in L.A. making a name for himself.
Look at the height and the control on the landing. Very difficult full twisting double back. And she shows off the flexibility, the extension in those leaps.
Even the gymnasties are getting into it. They don't do this for very many away teams. Well, one guy's yawning, but the others are bopping their heads.
Oh, they want to get up and move. You have to get up and move with this. Good pass here. More amplitude. The height of her tumbling is just spectacular. And I guarantee you, in a different arena, this place would be rocking. But this illustrates the benefit of competing at home. And this is what I meant with Auburn. They can't just rely on their enthusiastic crowd to come up with great gymnastics. Because look at what she's doing. She is putting on a show and a clinic for tumbling. Great job.
Mari Celestine certainly being her own energy there and following up Hannah Horton's fall in a major way. Here is Cassie Stevens. Had a 9.875 last week on beam and kept her composure while the crowd was erupting for LSU's Aaliyah Finnegan scoring a 10 on floor.
And take a moment to just think, that vault that she did at the beginning of this meet was the 200th performance she's done in college. So this is 203. The way she has contributed to this Auburn team, both in and out of the gym, she has been such a joy to watch throughout her career. It's been my pleasure. Here's her skill. It's called the Stevens. Her original skill.
I'm going to miss seeing that the most, I think.
Auburn is bringing it on beam. I know she wants the stick right here for senior night. Look at that. What a feeling. Good for her.
Still one routine to come inside Neville Arena. That's a great one, though, on beam.
I mean, what a way, your last balance beam performance in your home arena after such a tremendous career. It just doesn't get better than this. Joy.
And and competing for the all-around title with a 9.9985 on vault and bars, respectively. She is going to have a great shot heading to floor. But now here's Kennedy Griffin. Last week, her fourth score of 9.9 or better, and she's only competed on floor six times in college.
I love that open pose and the brushing off of the shoulder. This is an attention getter.
So is the Destiny's Child soundtrack that we get going on here. Favorite artist being Beyonce. This is towards the beginning of their catalog because it's the beginning of Kennedy's career. How about Beyonce becoming the first black woman to top the Hot Country charts as well with Texas Hold'em?
Beautiful pike double back. I love that they are just bringing it. They are entertaining, performing this full out, and it's not easy to do when the audience is sitting on their hands. Job.
I mean, you can see, Kathy, why they're the number seven team in the country on floor. It's their best event because they're just able to do it. It travels. And like we were saying with Auburn, you know, you need to make it portable. And Missouri has figured out how to make floor portable.
It was interesting. I talked to some of the athletes from Auburn after last week's meet where they competed at LSU. And that's a hard arena to compete in for an away meet. And I said, well, what do you think people feel like when they come here? Like, oh, I get it.
All right, look at these scores. 9.75 from Brush is the one that's about to be dropped. If we get a hit from Gabby McLaughlin, they'd count three scores of 9.9 at the moment, one of 9.85.
Her beam work is just stunning. So precise. The details from the tips of her fingers. Oh, no!
No!
That is not what I anticipated at all. Oh my goodness.
Under the pressure of senior night. I mean, you do not see that very often at all from Gabby.
No, and it takes nothing away from the beauty of her beam work, but it is a shame because she is usually so solid on this event, especially under pressure. That is something that she does well. To remind her these women are human and they're competing week after week. Under the pressure of team, because these teammates mean so much to each other. Gorgeous pike gainer off the end. She is not going to be happy with that, especially because they have the lower score they want to drop. So as I said, every skill in gymnastics has a setup, a follow-through, and finish, and you have to do all three because everything is connected. It's like dominoes. She was off in the air, and I could see it. It would have been really, really difficult because her center of gravity was off to the left side of the beam. That's a really hard thing to fix. Not impossible, but pretty much.
That beam only 4 inches wide, too. So that is the score that Auburn is going to drop. That means the 9.75 for Aria Brush will count. They were going towards a huge beam rotation, maybe even a season high, but not anymore. Let's see how Jocelyn Moore anchors Missouri on floor.
Every year I look forward to her routine. The music, the Afrobeat, I just love it.
And following up the 9.9 from Kennedy Griffin, which means Hannah Horton's 9.175 with a hit gets dropped.
Check this out, double layout. Oh my gosh, and sticks it.
Mm-hmm.
I love that their teammates are around the floor so they can dance and make eye contact with them. And she told us she loves to look right at the audience, right in the eyes. And dare you not to be entertained.
And make you come back.
Look at that front through to a high tuck double back. She was over her coach's head. Do you see Shannon Welker in the background? That's some height.
Amazing. Jocelyn hasn't scored lower than a 9-9 her last 10 routines. It could very well be 11 right here.
This is just an exciting routine. I mean, I really find myself on the edge of my seat watching. I love her expressive dance. And look at it, Coach Shannon. Fist pump. Boy, when you get a fist pump, that's it.
There's Jackie and Andre, mom and dad. They're busy filming. They're nervous. I get it. I get the nerves. But I think they're going to be very happy once that score comes in here for Jocelyn Moore. They need a 9-8 to take the lead. We will see if they get there. All right, we've got plenty more to come on the other side. Three rotations in the books. One more to come. What a meet it has been. Tigers versus Tigers in the heart of the SEC season down on the Plains. Is certainly feeling the boom as well. The average attendance up 37% since post-COVID, and then a million average viewers. What a number for the national championship last year on ABC. And that's translated locally to Neville Arena as well. A sellout every meet the last three seasons.
And now to the conference awards. SEC Gymnast of the Week, Kentucky's fifth-year senior, Raina Worley, who won her 26th career all-around and earned her first 10-0 on the bars. SEC Co-Specialists of the Week were LSU junior Aaliyah Finnegan, who scored her fifth career 10, her third time to score it on floor exercise, and Missouri's Mara Titarsoli, a senior from the Netherlands, made history at the Mizzou to the Loop, hosting Missouri's first perfect 10 on bars in program history. And Freshman of the Week, Anya Pilgrim, who tied for third all around at that meet, the Mizzou to the Loo.
Well, don't go anywhere, because you'll get a chance to see the reigning SEC Gymnast of the Week, Raina Worley, number two in the all around nationally. And that's at 8:30 Eastern when we are done. And Frankie Price is electric on floor. You do not want to miss her. Close it out for Jordan Weaver's Arkansas Gymbacks. Our score after three. Missouri has taken the advantage, 148-025 to 147-85. But in the final rotation, they can certainly make that up. Missouri will try to hold him off on beam with Sienna Schreiber, the highlight, and then on floor. We can't wait to see Olivia Hollingsworth in the anchor spot next. We're grooving into the fourth and final rotation inside Neville Arena. A razor tight meet here between Missouri and Auburn, as we expected. The Gymnasties are getting ready to do their job, though, with Auburn going to floor. Missouri extended their lead to 0.175 after three, so Auburn a little bit of room to make up. Tigers have had an excellent meet so far. Kathy, what are we looking forward to in the fourth rotation?
Well, unfortunately, Auburn did not quite take advantage of being the great beam team that they've been all season long, so they had to count a low score. But Missouri needs to go to beam. This is one of their toughest events. They're ranked 22nd in the nation, so they have got to be at their best and hopefully come up with a season high on this event, because Auburn, they can knock it out of the park here, especially with the support of this home crowd.
This is exactly where Missouri wanted to be. They wanted to have just a little bit of cushion here going into the last rotation. And on beam, where they had a 49.25 last week, Amari Celestine starts off.
And any nerves they feel right now, they have to convert that to opportunity, to excitement, to focus.
How hard is that to do, though, Kathy, on the road?
It takes training, and this is how you prepare for postseason, because the meets just get tougher mentally. You've done these routines over and over, but being able to do them under pressure on an event like Beam, where there's very little room for error, and that was just, she did not settle into the beam and finish the skill. It's an interesting event because you can be slightly off, meaning your center of gravity can be off to one side, and with a little arm movement or more energy in one hand pulling to the side, you can pull that center of gravity back. But sometimes it's you overcorrect.
This is a really good beam rotation last year too, and Shannon Welker unfortunately lost half of last year's starting lineup, which finished 11th. So he's been plugging and playing here and trying to find out what his best six are going to be as you get closer towards postseason. All right, well, Missouri with a fall to start things off from Celestine, and now the door is open for Auburn. And Aria Brush, her final floor routine inside Neville Arena.
And this can be a really emotional moment, but oh, so special.
Coach Jeff Graba just calls her the glue. No nonsense, always reliable, leads off on everything, sacrifices her scoring potential for the best of the team.
And a very powerful glue, I can tell you that.
Her a super glue.
Is how she can really, exactly. She can really get off the floor. To that line, you can touch the line, you just can't go over it, otherwise it's an out-of-bounds deduction. I think she managed to keep it within bounds, and as I said, this is emotional for these seniors, especially graduate student here, and what a career, what leadership she has provided. Such a great role model. So all you young gymnasts out there watching, understand how much hard work that these women put in every day.
Monday 9 Eastern, a 3.5 hour recap coming up of this weekend's SEC Indoor Track and Field Championships from the Randall Tyson Indoor Track Center in Fayetteville. Catch all the action. It's right here on SEC Network and streaming on the ESPN app. And back to Beam we go. Celestine's score was 9-1-7-5. Clearly that is the one they want to drop, and what pressure on Raina Light's shoulders, the freshman from the Tampa Bay area.
Triple series right here. Two back handsprings to a layout step out. She looked just a little bit cautious, almost like she's holding back a little bit. Kind of, as I said, you really have to be aggressive and attack on this event.
I mean, when your leadoff falls, though, Kathy, how much does that rattle you?
It adds a layer of pressure, but this is, we call it a reset. It's just a reset. They practice these scenarios to prepare themselves for this kind of feeling. So you can see even her dance, her choreography is just a little bit cautious, doing things a little small, but she got through it, hit this routine, that is a stick.
A clean is basically the most important thing right there.
So watch this, by cautious, I just mean everything's a little small, not going really, really high, really big. She just almost didn't want to leave the beam, but then she just attacked that landing, so really proud of her, just a freshman.
It certainly is a hit. Her career high coming into tonight was a 9-8. So we'll see what her score comes in as Hannah Hagel follows up Aria Brush's 9.85. Hagel just entered the floor lineup 4 meets ago, didn't compete on floor at all last year as a freshman.
One of the requirements on floor is to do a combination pass with two different somersaults. She actually twists both of these. Back 1.5 twist to a front full. A nice level of difficulty. This turn here, it's called a wolf turn. She's going to do a double, and she needs to complete it. She needs that skill for her start value. Well done. Nice, clean form in her tumbling. Even the roundup back hand's been very clean. Good amplitude on the double back. So the gymnasts earn bonus points for doing skills of difficulty or combinations. This is a dance skill that's worth, it's a D, so she needs that skill. Look at the smile on her face. Has to get both two of those revolutions in that turn. Great job. Oh, look at Cassie's reaction. That's awesome.
Auburn has to make up 0.175 here in this final rotation, and now it's really going to come down to the end of this Missouri beam lineup, because Raina Light scored 9.775. That's going to have to count. And Amaya Marshall took a great step forward, according to Shannon Welker, last week with a season-high 9.875.
This is her acro series. Oh, my goodness. So in order to get credit for that as an acro series, you cannot have a balance break in between the two skills. You have to keep moving. They have to be directly connected. So it'll be interesting to see how strict the judges are on that. She did keep her arms moving. Nice elevation on those jumps. Full split in the air, and that's called a double stag. The second jump. Through easy. She makes everything look so easy. I like that aspect of her gymnastics. We'll see what the judges do with that start value, that front aerial to the back handspring. Not quite sure she connected perfectly, but like that elevation on her dismount.
All signs pointing towards positivity for Auburn at the moment, with Hannah Hagel tying her career high with a 9.9 to follow up Aria Brush's 9.85. And you have four to end this floor rotation who can put up some massive scores, starting with Sophia Groth. 6 straight scores of 9.95 or better on floor.
Sophia also does an E skill for her first pass. She does it with a front double twist.
They can really put a lot of pressure on Missouri here if Auburn continues to hit on floor.
Float on that front layout, an excellent shape in the air. So to get these really high scores, you really want to see the gymnast go above and beyond in every area. She's shown really nice amplitude and extension, clean form. Finishes with a Rudy, great control on the landing. really good routine. I love how clean and precise her footwork is on floor exercise. Every time a foot leaves the floor, it points. It leaves the floor pointed. And this is that very difficult front double twist. Oh, look at that. That's awesome. Take a picture of that.
Sophia must have eaten her bagel this morning. That's her superstition. Every meat day, she has a bagel. Had a great night here for Auburn, trying to close out Missouri. It's going to be up to Sydney Schaefer to boost these scores. A couple of 9-7-7-5s counting at the moment.
Sydney also does a triple series, two back handsprings into a layout step out. Fight.
Stayed on.
Always better to stay on and not fall. All the extra arm swings, and when you lift your leg or lean, any of those by themselves is a deduction. All three is a bigger deduction.
At this point, though, I mean, you would have to say Auburn is really in the driver's seat to win this meet and put up a great score.
See just a little bit of nerves. The legs are just not really strong beneath her. That comes with time and experience. Nice job, though, with that round off 1.5 twist. So she knew she was nervous, and right when you are nervous, you have to really attack that end position and be strong in the core, strong with the feet. See how they're rocking from side to side. She just got the wobbles, and but she saved it, as you said, saved the fall.
And here is Gabby McLaughlin, who not only competes on floor, she choreographs on floor. And Cassie Stevens, who follows her, cuts most of that music. It's a real team effort in so many different ways here for the Tigers.
Multi-talented women.
And back-to-back 9-9s following up Aria Brush's 9-8-5 for Hagel and Groth. Now they're really just trying to put a great score together.
This is the beauty of gymnastics and team sports. Gabby had a mistake on beam, but she can come back strong here. Leaps. The wolf, that front leg could be a little bit higher, but the toe point is so beautiful. She makes such pretty pictures. Now watch on this double pike final pass. How she keeps her toes pointed. I love the form in the air. Right to the landing. Well done. Great comeback
from
me.
That's how you go out.
Yep. So many special things in this routine. To be able to keep your toes pointed, the moment the second they leave the floor, they point, even as she skips into that final choreography. Love to
and
see
to
it.
Hit your final routine at home just has to feel so good, so satisfying. How much you've put in and how much these fans have given you. I mean, we talked about it. This is the third straight year that they've sold out every single meet. I mean, what a joy it must be to compete inside Neville Arena.
Especially when keep in mind, these women started this sport when they were little girls. They have been doing this for most of their lives.
Now Grace Ann Davis. 9-7 is the score for Sydney Schaefer. Well, they should be Auburn's meet if they can finish strong with Stevens and Hollingsworth. But remember, 196.6 is the number for Missouri. Even if they don't come in here and win, and on the plains, they can improve their NQS next week if they can score a 196.6, better than a 196.6.
She fought hard to say that she had a fall last week on that acro series, so I'm really glad she fought through to the end and kept it on. That is a win each week if you can improve or overcome something. That is always the goal in this sport. Difficult sheep jump. Don't ask me why it's called a sheep jump. It's a strange name, but you arch back and you really try to touch your head with your toes, and it is as hard as it looks.
That one's not named after anybody.
Oh, look at that elevation. Really nice amplitude on the dismount. Unfortunately, took the step forward, but good fight there in the middle of that routine, because she could have easily stepped off the beam.
In the all-around competition through three rotations, here is where we are at. Cassie Stevens has the lead. Sophia Groth's score was a 9-9, so she's going to put the pressure on her. But this is the last time that we get to see Cassie Stevens out on the floor here in Auburn. She will be back, though, inside, just not competing as a grad assistant next year. That is going to be really exciting, getting her master's in biomechanics as
we speak. Getting
married.
She's going to come back as a married woman, and wow.
And Sophia Groth is going to be her maid of honor.
With a combination pass here, a layout into a Rudy, a 1.5 kiss.
By the way, that scored Grace Ann Davis 9-8, the highest that Missouri has seen. So building in the right direction with one more to go.
And you recognize that skill, the Stevens from the beam. She also does it on the floor. Gymnastics have Let's Meet Cancer. This is Cancer Awareness Meet, the Pink Meet. What a finish. What
beautiful.
Beautiful final routine for her in this arena. She has given so much to Auburn. They love her. She loves them back. This is just special.
You can't help but smile. And I'm sure there are some tears down on those Auburn teammates as they huddle up and rejoice on a job well done for Cassie Stevens. She needed a 9-9 or better to win the all-around competition in her final home meet as well, as we await her score to come in. At the moment, the lowest for Auburn is a 9.85, and now the final gymnast for Missouri on beam is an excellent one, Sienna Shriver.
Also a graduate student, so many years spent in a gym perfecting these skills. It takes a very special human that wants to do these things over and over and over again, always striving for that perfection. Layout, step out, nice straight legs.
There's Cassie Stevens' score, 9.95. So she goes out a champion. Set a new career high at that.
Switch off to split jump. You can see the confidence that she has just trained into herself all these years, competing, and often in this anchor spot, she can be money for Missouri. Great job again. Way to finish.
That should be something that maybe Missouri can take a bit of momentum with into their next meet, because this is all Auburn here tonight with a huge final rotation. They left absolutely nothing up for grabs, and Missouri faltered on beam. We'll see what Schreiber's score comes in as, because remember, they are trying to build their NQS, and if, again, higher than a 196.6, they do just that. Talk about final floor routine as a Tiger. In home, it is Olivia Hollingsworth's time. Massive scores, Kathy, here for Auburn on floor, and they could cap it off with a big one. This is going to end up being a score that they're going to look back on and really be proud of.
Phenomenal so far, and she opens really big. I love this first pass. It's a full out. Watch how she waits on the first somersault, is open, and then she twists the full on the second one. So difficult, so well done. Nice extension on the leaps. I love that she's looking around, making eye contact. The performance quality is so lovely. And she's soaking in the moment.
All those fans on their feet here.
Front through to a double back. And a great landing. What a senior night. I can't even imagine the feeling. I mean, and this is a student athlete who is going to be off to med school, and she does have another year of eligibility if she wants. We have no idea what she's going to do, but enjoy this moment. As a senior, you've done so much, done it so beautifully, and with such passion.
I mean, if that's the final one, not a bad way to go out. We'll wait on Hollingsworth's final score. Sienna Schreiber's at 9.925, which means mission accomplished in some ways for Missouri. They're not going to win the meet, but they do post a 197 road score.
Our minor fans, stick around right after awards as we honor tonight's seniors.
And so Auburn needed a strong meet here at home. They get a chance to finish the year on the road. So a lot of their ranking is going to go into that. But there's a lot of celebration going out there on the floor. It is a career high for Hollingsworth. 9.95. That is just awesome.
That is the cherry on top. And you know what's so exciting, too, for this Auburn team? Their former teammate, Suni Lee, Olympic champion, is actually competing this weekend as well. She went back to elite. Her health is good. She's excited to be there. So a lot of really exciting things for these Auburn fans. What a moment for these seniors and the team.
And in her final meet at Neville Arena, Cassie Stevens wins the all-around, and Auburn takes down Missouri. Still, the Tigers have never won here inside Neville Arena. Kathy, this was fun.
Oh, absolutely. I enjoyed every minute of it.
And so Missouri loves that 197 as they will go home after this. That will do it for us here with Kathy Johnson-Clark for our entire crew. I'm Alex Perlman saying so long. Let's get you out to Fayetteville for more Friday Night Heights, Kentucky and Arkansas.